Well, hello, I'm Mike Festiva. In this video, we're actually going to be checking out the options and features of these two AC-DC machines sold from Harbor Freight. They're both AC-DC TIGs, so they can weld aluminum, steel, and stainless steel. They're both high-frequency start, which is nice, and they're both stick welders. So we're going to actually dive in deep on the features of these things, going over them, and hopefully by the end of the video, you understand enough about each of these machines that if you decide to get one, you know which one's going to be the best for you. All right, enjoy the video. So this is a Vulcan ProTig 205. It's a full-fledged AC-DC TIG machine and stick welder. It's got high-frequency start. It's got lots of parameter settings you can get into. If you're brand new to TIG welding, it might be a little daunting figuring out all the settings, but I actually did a full review of this machine. So if you want to see every feature on this thing and how to set it up and get it ready for welding aluminum, check the description down below. There'll be a link to that video I did about a year ago. Like I've said, I've had this for about a year now. I've only had the titanium for about 6 months. I've done a lot more welding with this, and I really like this machine. If you want to get in there and dial in all your settings, you got pre and post flow, pull settings, all that kind of stuff. This machine, it seems to be very well built, robust. It's about 50 pounds, and I've been really just happy with it. We'll go in a few more features up front here. We'll turn it on. We'll go over some of those features, and then we'll jump over to the titanium, and then we'll get into comparing the two and how they differ. All right, so I plugged this thing into 120 volts, and we're gonna turn it on here. It's got a nice digital display. Keep in mind, both these machines are dual voltage, so 120 and 240. The fan's fairly noisy when it kicks on, but it ramps off, so it'll shut off in a little bit here, and it won't kick on again until you start welding, and then it'll run for 2 or 3 minutes after you're done welding and go down again. I really like that, mainly because when I'm trying to shoot these videos in the shop, it's kind of hard to talk over a really loud fan. So here's a close-up of this. Here's the process button. We'll go down to stick first. And here's DC stick. You just adjust your amperage with the knob right here. There's not much you can do on the stick settings. Right now it maxes out at 80 amps on 120 volts, but if you go up to 240, you can get full range out of it. This is DC TIG. It's got a bunch of settings in here for DC. This is coarse start, goes back to your amp. We'll go up here as a pre-flow. That's how long your gas runs for before you start welding. Post-flow, pulse on or off. Background amps for your pulse, peak time, pulse frequency. Now we're back to amps. Now we'll go up to AC, and it has a few more parameters. So here's where you just adjust your main high amps. This is pre-flow for gas. You can adjust that. This is AC frequency. You got a wide range of adjustments down to 50 hertz all the way up to 160. I usually leave it around 120 and just forget it. AC balance, 66 I found works great. Post flow, that's how long your gas flows for after you're done welding. Pulse on or off. Background amps. Peak time. Pulse frequency. Back to setting your main amps. So all these settings here might be a little daunting for some people. I myself like digging in and learning what each one of these do and diving in deeper and fine tuning the machine. But honestly, once you get it dialed how you like it, I don't really mess with many of them. Might just the pulse on occasion. It's really, once you get it dialed in how I like to weld, I don't find myself changing AC balance much or the frequency of it or anything like that. But this machine has a few other little funny features. Like this is kind of interesting. It's got this little cubby you can keep consumables up here and tungsten, stuff like that. Everything that comes on this machine feels pretty well built. The torch is okay. It's nothing amazingly quality, but it's still working just fine. This is one thing that I think sets this thing apart quite a bit, is it's got a nice, robust, really sturdy feeling foot pedal. Another cool thing is this pedal crosses over from the Omni Pro to the Pro TIG, so it's the same pedal between the machines. And another thing is, I think most Harbor Freight stock these, which is kind of nice in case you smash it or for some weird reason back to vehicle over it. You can get another one easily. The connection's another little thing. It's just a small little part, but the connections on this machine are really nice. It's got these gold-plated terminals here with a rubber O-ring in it. Just feels like a really well-built connection up front. Came with a ridiculous amount of line for it. It's probably 25 feet worth of cable for that pedal. The regulator that came with this one, it's not a nice flow meter or anything, but the actual regulator that came with this thing works is pretty good. I've been running it for a year now and I haven't decided to replace it yet. So the regulator comes with this. It comes with separate power cords, very nice casing on them. They're very flexible. This is a 240 power cord, and it's got a twist lock on the back of the machine, so you get a 110 volt and a 240 volt power plug, which is nice. The stick lead isn't crazy quality, but it's definitely higher end than the one that comes with the titanium here. And I haven't done a lot of stick welding with this. I have a bunch of stick welders. I don't usually jump over to this one. You can stick weld with it. I'm sure it works just fine. I just usually do a lot more MIG and TIG in my shop. So here's the ground lead, and the ground clamp is actually pretty robust on here. It doesn't feel like anything you're gonna burn out anytime soon. It feels like it's gonna last for a while. I've seen heavier duty ground clamps than this, but I've also seen a lot shabbier. So it's pretty decent. This runs a DINS 50 on the front, so it's super universal plug-in, very simple. We'll spin around the back. I'll show you guys the back side of the machine too. It's got this enormous fan on the back, and overall, it's about a 50, 55 pound machine. It just feels really well built. So there's that beefy fan on the back of this thing. It definitely moves a lot of air. So now this machine is the Titanium 200 TIG, and it's a lot more simplified, basically really straightforward to use right out of the box. It does not have pulse. It does not have pre and post flow adjustments. Basically, you plug it in, you turn on your gas, set your gas flow, set your amps, also set what you want to do process. You want to do DC stick, DC TIG, AC TIG. Step on the foot pedal and start welding. There's really not that much to setting this thing up. You just dial in your amps and you're good to go. Basically, this takes any of the guesswork out of setting the machine up. I was going over with my buddy Dave recently and talking to him about the two different machines, and he's got a nice Miller Dynasty that he uses every 6 months or so, and he gets kind of lost in the parameters. And by describing how basic this machine was, which sometimes feels a little bit like a negative thing to me, he's like, you know, Mike, for something simple for a guy like just uses a TIG on occasion, I kind of would like to just have a machine you turn on, set your amps and start rolling. It takes all the guesswork out. It's all automatically set in there. Some of you guys may not like that, but some of you might enjoy that. So we'll dive a little bit more deep into this machine as well. So I'm gonna plug the Titanium 200 into 120 volts. And just like I was talking earlier, those line adapters, here's what you get, 240 volt plug. And you plug this little adapter in and it makes it 120 volts. Really moving a lot of air right there. It's also got an automatic on-demand fan, which is nice. Again, it comes on when you start welding and it stays on for a few minutes and turns itself back off until you start welding again, which is nice. Another nice feature. Again, like I said, I do these videos, so it's nice to be able to talk and not have the fan blaring the whole time. So basically you have this little process button's just like a finger pointing at it, same as the process button here. So you go down to DC stick, AC TIG, or DC TIG. Again, it goes up to 110 amps on 120 volt plug-in. Really simple. Basically, when you want to weld with this machine, say you want to do some AC aluminum welding, you go up to AC, you have the machine on, you have your regulator hooked up, dial in your gas flow, set your amps, hook up your clamp, set up your foot pedal, and you start welding. There's really not much else. It's all automatic on here. One thing I want to point out about this machine though is the amp pedal. It's definitely not something you're gonna write home about. I'm not very happy about this pedal. Keep in mind, it fully functions. It's like the size of a lunchbox, you know, something you would take like a He-Man lunchbox when you're a kid to school. It's big. I mean, it's probably gonna hold up, but it's just one of those things. Like, I mean, I've seen some small welders that are almost the size of this foot pedal. So I really wish they could have stepped it up and just made a little lower profile foot pedal for it, something a little nicer. And the plug-in, it's got little gold-plated terminals, but they feel fairly cheap. But I mean, I've seen this kind of plug-in on a lot of welders, but it definitely doesn't come close to the one that comes on that Vulcan over there. So this part of the video, I really want to cover the pros and cons of the machines. So we're gonna start off with the Titanium 200. So I'd say the pros for this machine are, it's really basic and simple setup. If you're just starting out learning TIG, or if you're a person that gets overwhelmed with settings too much, or you only TIG weld on occasion every 3 or 4 months and you come back to your machine, you're not maybe gonna be lost in the parameters. This thing's basically automatic, so you don't have to figure out pre or post flow adjustments for your gas. You don't have to figure out EC balance or anything. Just welds out of the box pretty well. So I think that's a benefit for some. It's also high frequency start on AC and DC, plus it's a stick welder. And another thing, it's a dual voltage, 120 volts and 240, which is nice. It's compact, it's got that on-demand fan, and it's basically ready to go right out of the box. So I think that's a plus side, and it's fairly affordable TIG. So I'd like to cover my feeling on the cons on the Titanium 200, the things I don't care about as much. And again, it's the pedal. The pedal is giant. It's bulky. It does vary the amperage just fine. It worked just fine, but I think they could have paired a much more compact, nicer pedal with this thing, which is just give it a better feeling of quality, like you got a better rounded out kit here. Because this is a basic machine, automatic and everything, you see what you see is what you get. And for somebody that's starting out learning TIG, it's probably not going to make them overwhelmed. But if you get more experience in TIG welding, you don't have any pulse features to adjust or AC balance, anything like that. I really wish this button pushes in but doesn't do anything. I really wish they would have added, like, maybe you could push that in and assign like a super simple pulse setting. Even if it was just one pulse setting that the factory set up in here, it would have been nice to have something to dive into for if you want to play around with that. But it is what it is, so there's no pulse on this machine. And the regulator here, the regulator that came right out of the box, I hope they're not all like this, but the one I got doesn't read very well. I set it up to where it should have been, about 18 cubic feet per hour for argon flow to start off with, and it was acting really weird. It was blowing the arc all around, and I realized it reads really wrong, so I have to turn it way down. So I'd highly recommend, if you got this machine, play around with that if you're having a hard time welding, because this gauge, at least on mine, isn't reading very well. And I'd really just recommend just going out and ordering and buying one of those argon flow gauges or flow meters. They work a lot better for TIG welding. So the pros on the Vulcan 205 are, it's a very well-built machine. It feels pretty robust. It's got a large fan, which is also on demand, which is nice. So it moves a lot of air for cooling it. It's got a better duty cycle than the titanium. The pedal is more compact, but very stout, much more well-made. It's got a nice screen full of features and options. Once you get used to getting around the parameters, it's very easy to set up. This is not a big thing, but it is kind of nice to keep extra tungsten and some consumables up in the front pocket up here, the little cupboard. Everything about it, you know, you don't have to use a power adapter to go from 120 volts to 240. You got the dual separate leads, which are nice. So you got those twist locks on the back for that. The regulator, this one's I've been running for a year. It's been no problem. You know, you're always better off getting a flow gauge or flow meter, but this regulator works fine right out of the box. I just feel like the fit and finish on this one's a bit nicer, but it does cost more. So what's the downside of the Vulcan 205? Well, honestly, I don't really see many downsides to it. It actually works very well. It's a good machine. I guess the cost, it's a few hundred dollars more than the titanium, but granted, it comes with a nicer pedal, nicer regulator, and a few other nice features with all those extra settings. So for me, I don't really see that cost being a little bit more as being really a downside for what you're getting here. So if you noticed earlier in the video, I overlaid some welding shots while I was talking about each machine. And here's some of the results and some small coupons. This is 6061 aluminum. And, you know, I haven't actually TIG welded any aluminum for about 3 or 4 months, so I'm really not in the best of practice. But here's what I got with just a few tries with these coupons here. And I'm sure a more skilled aluminum TIG welder could lay down better beads. But both machines work good. The Vulcan I'm very happy with. The titanium actually welds really well, just the automatic settings out of the box. The biggest thing for my titanium there was the gas regulator. It threw me for a loop when I first hooked that machine up. So I hope that's not common for a lot of them. Hopefully I just got a dud with a bad regulator on this one. But yeah, if you end up getting a kind of erratic arc and it seems to be rushing a lot of gas flow out of your nozzle, consider dialing down your regulator. Maybe your gauge is reading improper too. Hopefully it's just a one-time thing and I got a bad one. But I hope you enjoyed seeing these little welding coupons here. And like I said, a little more practice, you lay down some better welds, but it'll stick the aluminum together no problem. And it's kind of nice, gratifying to be able to weld that aluminum together. Both machines out of the box work pretty well. All right, so before we finalize the video here, I want to actually mention who I think this machine is probably built and geared towards compared to this machine here. So the titanium we'll start off with first. Basically, I think it's for the person that just likes to keep it nice and simple, is interested in dabbling with occasional TIG welding, wants to not get overwhelmed with complex settings, wants to turn on the machine, set your gas flow, set your amperage, set your process, and start welding. Now you can weld steel, stainless steel, and aluminum with it, and it does pretty well with that. Somebody that doesn't want to try to remember a bunch of different settings, just want to weld and go. It's a pretty simple machine, and that can appeal to some people. I think it's a good starter machine. It could probably simplify the learning curve for some people if they don't want to dabble around with understanding the fundamentals of AC balance and things like that. This is probably the machine for that person. So the person I think the Vulcan's more geared towards is somebody that actually doesn't mind getting in a little bit deeper in the parameters, playing around with AC balance and frequency and things like that, and dabbling a bit more in fine tuning their welds. It seems to be very well built. So I think if you're going to be doing a lot of TIG welding, especially aluminum, I think this would be probably the preferred machine in your shop. I think it's actually well built enough to where you could actually do some light duty production work with this thing. If you're actually starting to knock out a bunch of aluminum parts in your shop, you're maybe trying to sell on the side. I think this thing's going to be holding up pretty well for you for that. Another thing is, I feel like if you're really doing a lot of thin aluminum, stainless steel, this machine is going to be better for you for that as well, because it has the pulse settings on there. You can fine tune those. So that's basically a hotter cycle and then a cooler cycle on a square wave. So you can actually not put too much heat into your metal components. So this thing has a lot more parameters you can dive deeper into. Honestly, this is my favorite one, but I do like getting in there and fine tuning features and dialing them in and just understand what the parameters do. But that's the person I am. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and you can take something away from it. Hopefully you've learned something. In case you're looking at these two machines at Harbor Freight and contemplating which one might be better for you, hopefully you learned a lot in this video. This is only fitting that I compare the Titanium versus the Vulcan here and the AC-DC TIG machines, because if you guys have followed my channel, I've kind of compared the multi-process Titanium to the Vulcan in the past. So it's kind of fitting to come out with this video and kind of show the differences and kind of explain more about the process. Another thing I want to point out is, if you're really interested in the Vulcan here, I did a very thorough review on that machine. I'll put a link down below in the description so you can understand the settings. We get into fully welding aluminum with that. Another thing, if you're just scratching the surface on TIG welding or want to learn more, I also have a how-to TIG welding 20-minute video. Basically, I made a video that I could not find years ago when I was trying to teach myself how to TIG weld. I take all the information I've learned over the last 3.5-4 years and condense it into one video. And it shows you basically the fundamentals from sharpening a tungsten, setting up how you hold the torch, how to set up your machine, and the TIG weld steel. The next video I'm going to come out with is going to be how to TIG weld aluminum. So that jumps into some more technical steps. But if you're welding steel or aluminum, I highly recommend you watch that video. It gives you a lot of information. It's just a video I wish I could have found 4 years ago when I was teaching myself. If you're not subscribed yet, please consider subscribing. Give it a thumbs up and leave a comment down below. Till next time. Take care. Bye.